So we got Game Informer top 50 games of 2016. Xbox, you know. obviously ASMR, or I've tried to do ASMR, but with horror games, you never really know exactly what it's going to be like. I'm going to have the mic more towards the controller, though, I think. Okay, so here we go. Top 50 games of 2016. Alright. Here we go. Let's really quick talk about the, 2016. The future interactive entertainment gets into its lifespan. The more it diversifies and breaches new realms, the year 2016 was no different. It marked the birth of three new virtual reality platforms, the continued meteoric growth in esports, and mid-generation console refreshes that offer players better hardware, performance, and improved visuals. We watched the Pokemon Go craze spread around the world. Popular games from years past staying in regular rotation with gamers, thanks to the strong post-release support from developers and brand new titles like Blizzard's Overwatch Breakthrough in highly competitive genres. The year was so good that culling our list of the best games to just 50 standout titles was harder than usual. Many good high-scoring games with impassioned fan bases or novel innovations didn't make the cut, even though they would have been shoo-ins another year. This is a great problem to have. The next 30 pages will give you a great sense of 2016's highs and lows, and it serves as one hell of a buyer's guide if you're still playing catch-up. There we go. That's the keyword. The top 50 has something for everyone, whether you're looking for high school high-octane blockbuster or reflective indies. These are our selections for the best 50 games of 2016, ordered by release date. Okay, guys, so if you're behind, this is your moment to catch up. We have Blade and Soul, Darkest Dungeon, The Witness. No, I think that was actually free at one point. XCOM 2, Firewatch. I have Firewatch, I haven't finished it. Street Fighter 5, Plants vs. Zombies Garden Warfare. Did that. Oh, sorry everyone, my leg was falling asleep. Did that really come out in 2016? That's crazy. I played a little bit of that. That's the only one on this page. These two are the only ones on this page that I really played much of. Fire Emblem Fates, Far Cry Primal, Super Hot, Stardew Valley. I have Stardew Valley. I haven't played much of it. I probably should, though. It's definitely my type of game. Clash Royale, The Division, Salt and Sanctuary, Chronos, Hyperlight Drifter, Dark Souls 3. My friend really wants me to play this. Uncharted 4. I actually haven't played this. I started to, but I've played the first three, but I haven't played that one. Doom. I haven't played Doom either. If there are any games that you guys see on here that you really want me to play, but you hear that I haven't played it yet, please let me know, because I would be willing to do a playthrough of them. Or at least one video playing them. I'm really bad with playthroughs. Overwatch. Definitely played that. I have it on all my consoles. Total Warhammer, Witcher 3, Wild Hunt, Blood and Wine, Inside. I played most of that, but then I stopped playing Witcher 3 for a little bit, and I'm having a difficult time getting back into it, but you never know. Maybe that time will come. Pokemon Go, played that. Overcooked, played that. Batman Telltale series, I haven't played that. No Man's Sky, I started playing that, but I was kind of disappointed, although I haven't played since the update, so. Madden NFL 17, The Turing Test, World of Warcraft, Legion. I haven't played Legion. I used to be an avid World of Warcraft player, but Stuff over here. Game of the Month, Dead Rising 4.